First, you'll need a freshly formatted SD card. If you don't know how to format, check out the video I linked in the description. Second thing you're going to need is the files, linked in the description as well. And all the files are going to be compiled in a zip folder. All you have to do is drag those files into root of the SD card. Avoid naming the SD card Wii U, as there has been reported issues when doing that. Once all files are copied to the root of the SD card, you want to eject it from the computer to safely remove the SD card. You're going to place the SD card in the front of the Wii U SD card slot. Make sure the console is off during this time. Once you boot it back, head over to the web browser. Head over to wiiuexploits.xyz. Click on Run Exploit, and then hold down B at the same time. The first thing we're going to do is going to be dumping the NAND. And then make sure everything is selected as yes. And then just go through it. And we're going to wait a couple minutes. Once the NAND is finished dumping, we're going to move on to the next step. We're going to go back to the Wii U exploit website, but this time we're going to be holding the X button. Next, we're going to be in the environment loader, and then you should see installer and Tiramisu. We're going to go into installer, go through it, and then click on install and install update. Read everything that's on the screen. Make sure that you're okay with it. And then click install. Once it's complete, just press A. It's gonna shut down the system. And then you have to power it back on yourself. Once it's turned back on, go into the health and safety app. And then we're back into the environment loader. And then we're gonna go into check. And then go down to boot options. And then switch to payloader. And then shut down again. And then it should go back into the environment loader when you turn on the system. And what you want to do is going to be selecting the Tiramisu to load once the Wii U is turned on. Just go down, click on Tiramisu, select it with a Y, and when it's highlighted, just press A. You're going to see this warning. It's okay, we're going to take care of that next. So, we're in the bootloader sector now. Choose Wii U menu with the Y, and then click A. And then go back into the Mii Maker. Double click Mii Maker. And you should be in the Homebrew Launcher. Once you're in the Homebrew Launcher, we're gonna go to UFDI on it, load it, and this is gonna help you remove that red screen. So the update folder exists. We're gonna click A to delete the update folder. There it is. I'll press home and exit. I'm gonna go ahead and restart my console after this. And it doesn't give you that red warning anymore. Yay! So we just took care of that. Now we're going to go into the Wii section. So once we're in Wii, you're going to click on the Homebrew channel. You're gonna wanna click on the D2X install, press X, and it should install pretty quickly. And click, we're gonna change a couple things in here. vWii, and then base 57, slot 249. Make sure to install that. For the next one, it's going to be base 56 and then slot 250. The vWii is going to stay the same, beta 52, for all three of them. And we have one more. It's going to be base 58 and then slot 251. Once that has finished installing, just press B. And we're going to be installing the iOS 80 installer next. When you're in the iOS 80 installer, it's going to bring you up to a screen. And just wait 30 seconds because it won't let you do anything. Once it shows that you can install, just press X and continue. And that's it. You're back into the Homebrew channel and it should be all installed. And we already set it up so when you boot, Tiramisu is already going to be loaded. So you don't have to be like manually booting it. Tiramisu is already auto-booted. You can now install different apps, emulators. You can also change the theme of your Wii. Stay tuned. Alright, so let's get into it. The first thing you want to do is go into the Mii Maker. And you should be in the Homebrew Launcher. Once you're in the Homebrew Launcher, you want to hit load. And then just wait for it to load. Once it loads, you're going to get to this screen. And then from here, we're going to go to the download content. And then you can see all the games that it has. Has a bunch of games. So I'm gonna download a demo real quick. Sonic Lost World. Downloaded files, I'm gonna put that as no. And yes, it's just a demo. So download quick. Just wait for it to download. Depending on your internet, it might take a while. So I'll just come back when it's done. Once it's finished downloading, it's going to install. And then once it's finished installing, just press any button. And then we're going to hit B to exit. And we're going to go back into the Wii menu. And the game should be loaded. Now what you want to do is click on it. Make sure that it worked. Okay, so everything is working. Let's create a game save. Alright, perfect. So it looks like everything's good. Go ahead and go through to the game. And now I'm gonna install app so you don't have to keep going into Mii Maker to launch it. To do that, we're gonna go back into the Mii Maker. Whoop, install it, load it, and then it's gonna take you to the gamepad. And on the gamepad, just put, it's not that big, I'm gonna go off with NAND and just wait for it to install. Once it's installed, just click OK, and then go back into the menu, and it should be there. And now you don't have to keep going back into Mii Maker. It's as simple as just clicking it, and you can download any game that you want. I'll be making another video to show you how to get Nintendo 64 and other different emulators, and also how to put themes on your Wii U. If you'd like to see those, check out my other videos. Stay tuned. I'll be dropping them later this week. Appreciate you guys. Thank you for watching.